Hello, I'm Dr. Beth Colby from Talk Mental Health. People with Charles Bonnet Syndrome experience visual hallucinations in the absence of mental illness or dementia. People experience these hallucinations when they have a sudden deterioration in eyesight, so that either all or most of their eyesight is lost. Now, a visual hallucination is seeing something outside somebody's mind, but that thing is not actually real, but the stimulus comes from inside the brain. And people with Charles Bonnet Syndrome know that what they're seeing is not real, unlike people with mental illness. People with Charles Bonnet Syndrome do not experience hallucinations in any other sensory domain. It was Charles Bonnet who first described the condition. He lived in the 18th century and was a Swiss scientist and philosopher. In Charles Bonnet Syndrome, people can experience one or both of two different types of hallucination. One is simple, where people just see lines or simple patterns. These may be very colourful and vivid, and the patterns or lines may cover everything that a person sees. The other type of hallucinations are known as complex hallucinations, where people see animals, people, objects, things, scenes, and people aren't people that they know, and the scenes that they see are not from memories of previous events. The hallucinations may move or they may be stationary. Hallucinations are more common in people who have lost sight in both eyes rather than one. And the actual vividness and complexity of the hallucination is not related to the degree of visual loss. It is more common in the elderly, as it is this population that most commonly experience sight loss. And over 100,000 people in the United Kingdom experience Charles Bonnet Syndrome. Characteristically, the hallucinations appear when somebody wakes up, and they can last from several seconds to hours on end. And these may recur every few days or months. The hallucinations may last seconds or hours and may recur every few days for years. They tend to become shorter and less frequent after about 18 months when the brain gets used to not having visual stimuli. Some people gain pleasure from the hallucinations, but for others it's annoying, although the hallucinations themselves don't tend to be scary. It can affect how people move around, especially if the hallucination is over the whole of their visual field. Some people talk to the characters or figures or people that they see, and this helps them feel some sort of control over the hallucination. Research has shown that most people, after 5 years of having the hallucinations, still occasionally experience them. And if the hallucinations do go away, they may return again once the eyesight deteriorates further. If the cause of the eyesight loss is reversible, such as removal of cataracts by surgery, then the hallucinations cease. The mechanism is unclear. However, when people are able to see, many signals go to the visual cortex. And when vision is suddenly lost, it's as if the brain is trying to fill in the gaps and neurons fire in the absence of incoming stimuli from the outside world. As regards treatment, there's no particular treatment that will remove all of the visual hallucinations. I think the most important thing is for people to be reassured that this is a totally normal experience for people with failing eyesight, although it will not affect everybody, and to be reassured that they're not suffering from mental illness or dementia. I think once the condition is explained, people feel much happier about the condition. Important things, though, are for a person to know their environment and sometimes altering the lighting, either by making it brighter or less bright, may affect the hallucinations. Some staring and blinking at the hallucinations and moving eyes from side to side has been known to help. Some medications, such as antipsychotic medication, can be used, although it does not completely eradicate the hallucinations and has side effects. It is important for the people who experience the hallucinations to be active both physically and mentally and spend time in the company of others to try and protect themselves from depression. And it's important for people to have a good rest and sleep well at night, as the hallucinations are more common when a person is tired or stressed. Thank you for listening. Bye for now.